বুক চ্যাপ্টার থেকে, চ্যাপ্টারটা বেরিয়েছে কিছুদিন আগে একটা বইতে। হ্যাঁ, এটা আমরা তিনজন অথার আছি, আমি লক্ষ্মীকান্ত মান্ডি, আমার ছাত্র কৌশিক রায় আমার কাছে পিএইচডি করেছে, এবং আমি এই থিমটা মোটামুটি ভাবে বলেছি, অ্যাপ্রক্সিমেট অ্যানালিটিক্যাল সলিউশন অফ নন লিনিয়ার ইভলিউশন ইকুয়েশনস। সো এখানে আমরা প্রিলিমিনারি যেটা বলেছি সেটা হচ্ছে যে ইভলিউশন ইকুয়েশন কাকে বলে, যে ইকুয়েশন গুলো টাইমের রেসপেক্টে ইভলভ করে, মানে কোনো একটা নন লিনিয়ার পার্সিয়াল ডিফারেন্সিয়াল ইকুয়েশনে যদি ডেল ডেল টি টার্মটা থাকে, তার সাথে আরো অন্য ডেরিভেটিভ বা অন্য কিছু থাকে, তখন আমরা বলি এটা ইভলিউশন ইকুয়েশন। সো ইভলিউশন ইকুয়েশনের সাথে যদি নন লিনিয়ার টার্ম থাকে, মানে বাকি যে এক্স ডেরিভেটিভ গুলো থাকে সেখানে যদি নন লিনিয়ারিটি অ্যাপিয়ার করে, তখন আমরা বলি নন লিনিয়ার ইভলিউশন ইকুয়েশন। হ্যাঁ, এখন যে কোনো ইকুয়েশনের অ্যানালিটিক্যাল সলিউশন বার করা যায় না, সেই জন্য এই ধরনের নন লিনিয়ার পার্সিয়াল ডিফারেন্সিয়াল ইকুয়েশনের আমরা বিভিন্ন টেকনিক দিয়ে অ্যাপ্রক্সিমেট অ্যানালিটিক্যাল সলিউশন বার করার চেষ্টা করি। এই চ্যাপ্টারটাতে এখানে আমরা চেষ্টা করেছি কিছু বিশেষ ধরনের নন লিনিয়ার ইভলিউশন ইকুয়েশনের সলিউশন বার করা বাই সাম অ্যাপ্রক্সিমেট মেথড, অ্যানালিটিক্যাল সলিউশন বার করা বাই সাম অ্যাপ্রক্সিমেট মেথড। দ্য মডেল ওয়াজ চুজেন ফ্রম প্লাজমা ডায়নামিক্স, আমি প্লাজমা থেকে মডেল গুলো নিয়েছি। ইউ নো হোয়াট ইজ প্লাজমা, প্লাজমা হচ্ছে ফোর্থ স্টেট অফ ম্যাটার, আমরা যাকে বলি পদার্থের চতুর্থ অবস্থা, সলিড লিকুইড গ্যাস, এই তিনটেকে যদি ফার্স্ট সেকেন্ড এন্ড থার্ড এই তিনটে স্টেট ধরি, তাহলে নেক্সট স্টেট হচ্ছে প্লাজমা। বিকজ সলিড থেকে লিকুইডে কিভাবে যায়, যখন টেম্পারেচার দেওয়া হয় সলিড থেকে, সলিডের মধ্যে যে ক্রিস্টাল ল্যাটিস স্ট্রাকচার আছে যেটা সলিডটাকে বেঁধে রাখে, সেইটা ভেঙে যায় এবং নতুন স্টেট ফর্ম করে, যেটাকে আমরা বলি লিকুইড। লিকুইডকে যখন আমরা আরো হিট দিই, ওয়েন এ লিকুইড ইজ হিটেড এনাফ সো দ্যাট দ্য ভেপারাইজেশন ইজ গ্রেটার দ্যান দ্য রিকন্ডেনসেশন, ওটা যখন আরো ফার্স্ট ভেপারাইজ করে রিকন্ডেন্স হওয়ার চাইতে, দেন উই গেট এ নিউ স্টেট হুইচ ইজ কল্ড গ্যাসিয়াস স্টেট। ওয়েন দ্য গ্যাস ইজ সাফিসিয়েন্টলি হিটেড সো দ্যাট দ্য মলিকুল স্প্লিটেড ইন্টু চার্জ পার্টিকলস, দেন ইট ইস কল্ড এ প্লাজমা স্টেট। সো প্লাজমা স্টেট আমরা স্টাডি করি বাই মেনলি বাই টু অ্যাপ্রোচ, ওয়ান ইজ কল কাইনেটিক থিওরি অ্যাপ্রোচ, থ্রু হুইচ মেনলি স্ট্যাটিস্টিক্যাল মেকানিক্স অ্যাপ্রোচ, গ্যাস ডাইনামিক্স ওটা ইউজ করা হয়। অ্যানাদার অ্যাপ্রোচ ইজ ফ্লুইড অ্যাপ্রোচ, বেসিক্যালি ফ্লুইড অ্যাপ্রোচ ফ্লুইড ফ্লো, ওয়াটার ফ্লো, ব্লাড ফ্লো এগুলোতে ইউজ করা হয়। বাট প্লাজমা ক্যান বি স্টাডিড বাই বোথ অফ দিস অ্যাপ্রোচ। অ্যাকচুয়ালি ইন দিস ওয়ার্ক আই ইউজ ফ্লুইড অ্যাপ্রোচ, সো অ্যাকর্ডিংলি ইকুয়েশন অফ কন্টিনিউটি, ইকুয়েশন অফ মোমেন্টাম ব্যালেন্স, পয়সো ইকুয়েশন, দি স্ট্যান্ডার্ড ফ্লুইড ইকুয়েশনস আর চোজেন। লাইক মেনি আদার ফিল্ডস, প্লাজমা ইজ এ নন লিনিয়ার ফিল্ড, সো অ্যাকর্ডিংলি নন লিনিয়ার ওয়েভস অ্যাপিয়ার ইন প্লাজমা। One particular type of solution, solitary wave solution, is very interesting in almost all areas. And the solitary wave study started with the famous work of Kortoek and Debris, who published in 1897 a famous equation, which is called KdV equation. But still, before this initiation of KdV equation, there is a history behind it. In 1834, a Scottish scientist and engineer, John Scott Russell, first noticed a wave, a heap of wave, while he was moving from Glasgow to Edinburgh in a channel. Glasgow-Edinburgh-Glasgow channel. While he was moving, he has seen that, he wrote in the report on waves, that I was observing the motion of the boat, while which was rapidly drawn along a narrow channel by a pair of horses. That is, he was sitting on the boat and the boat was carried out by the horses. When the boat suddenly stopped, not so the mass of water in the channel which it had put in motion. That is, হঠাৎ করে বোটটা থেমে যাওয়ার জন্য সামনে একটা হিপ ওয়াটার তৈরি হয়, and that wave moves in front of the boat. He he followed it on horseback and overtook it still rolling on the rate of some 8 or 9 miles an hour, preserving its original figure, some 30 feet long at a foot to the foot and a half its height. Its height gradually diminishes, and after a stage of 1 or 2 miles, I lost it in a winding of the channel. So এটা খুব সারপ্রাইজিং ঘটনা। আমরা সাধারণত দেখি যে পুকুর বা নদীতে ঢেউ তৈরি হলে ঢেউটা ভেঙে যাচ্ছে। But this is the first time what somebody have observed that a wave is moving without changing its shape and size, and he reported it. But still, he reported it in 1844. But still, people got not much interest on it. Later, in 1897. Porto again Bibris analytically or mathematically proved that okay, such type of wave, the presence of such type of wave is possible in shallow water waves, and they described the nonlinear partial differential equation, what is called Courtois Dibris equation. So this KdV, famous KdV equation. This is the famous KdV equation. What I am, del u del t plus a u del u del x plus b del c u del x c equal to 0. Del u del t, this is the evolution term. U del u del x is the nonlinear term. And del c u del x c, this is the dispersion term. If only presence of nonlinearity, the wave is injected energy after energy and it bursts out. And the only presence of dispersion, the wave disperses, but when the nonlinearity and dispersion balances each other and exactly balances, then a permanent shape appears, which is called solitary waves, or sometimes it's called soliton if a single peak is observed. So in this chapter, first what we do, we first see how a KdV equation can be derived from a plasma model. Then we shall find out how we can find out the approximate analytical solution of some damped KdV equation, forced KdV equation, etc., etc., etc. So now, derivation of the KdV equation. We derive this KdV equation from standard fluid equation. Equation 1 is the standard fluid equation, the equation of continuity. Del ni del t plus del del x of ni ui equal to 0. In fluid, this ni means density of the fluid. Here, in plasma, since density is not that here, the important thing is number density, that is number of charged particle, which is considered as a density. So ni is the number density, ui is the average velocity. Next equation, equation of motion. Del ui del t plus ui del ui del x equal to minus e by mi del psi del x. Del ui del t plus ui del ui del x equal to minus e by mi del psi del x. Here del del t plus u del del x, it is the du dt, standard Newton's law. And here right hand side, the force is there, F force. Force is the conservative field of force, so it become minus del psi del x, and mi is here. Mi came to the bottom. And equation 3 is the standard Poisson equation, epsilon 0 del square psi equal to E into Ne minus Ni. For Ne, we consider the motion of the ions, that's why this I is considered in, as a suffix of Ni, N and U. So motion of the ion in the background of electrons, and the electrons are having Maxwell Boltzmann distribution, that is E n 0 to the power E 5 by kT. So initially, while we study any such equation, we need to make the variable dimensionless. So equation 4 is shown the dimensionless. How do we make this thing dimensionless? So x is normalized by lambda d, that is d by length. T is normalized by omega p inverse, that is the inverse of the frequency. So t by omega 1 by omega p came on the top. Phi is normalized by k to e by e. Ni is normalized by n0. Ui is normalized by cs, that is ion elastic speed. And this is the expressions for lambda d, cs, omega pi, etc. So accordingly, if we do so, then equation 1 to 3 are converted into equation 5, 6, and 7. These equations look a bit simpler because all these physical parameters are already incorporated inside ni, ui, phi, etc. Now, suppose you want to find out, next step is linearization. What, how to linearize? That is, we consider that initially there was a stable state where phi equal to 0, that is no potential, no force and no potential. So, a potential equal to 0 initially. So, e to the power phi, that equal to 1, that is ni equal to 1. And ni, that is a certain disturbance, so ni equal to 1 plus ni bar. Ni bar is a very small quantity. So so there is a change of, there is a small change in the charge and due to the disturbance occur in the system. Suppose Ni will become 1 plus Ni, or 1 means Ni 0 equal to 1. So it will be, it is changed a little bit from the steady state. So accordingly, the velocities of the particle start. So let Ui equal to Ui bar, this is the small velocity. So small potential start, that is phi bar. So putting this thing, Ni equal to 1 plus n bar, phi equal to phi bar, ui equal to u bar, we get, instead of Ni equal to 1 plus Ni bar, ui bar. So accordingly, we got this equation, del Ni bar, del t bar, plus del phi I bar, del x bar equal to 0. Provided we neglect the term del del x of ni bar ui bar. This is the nonlinear term. So linearization means we remove the nonlinear term. So accordingly, from equation 6, equation 5, we have equation 9. From equation 6, if we use the same normal linearization to equation 6, we got equation 10. Here also, if we neglect this nonlinear part, ui bar del ui bar del x, we get equation 11. And similarly, from equation 7, we get equation 12. Now, these ui bar, phi bar, ni bar, all these are small perturbation parameter. And we assume that all these parameters vary as sinusoidally. So, instead of writing sin kx minus omega t or cos kx minus omega t, we write e to the power I into kx minus omega t. So let n bar equal to n0 e to the power I into kx minus omega t, u bar equal to u0 e to the power I into kx minus omega t, and phi bar equal to phi 0 into e to the power I into kx minus omega t. So accordingly, then n bar del t equal to I n0 I into del del t is minus I omega into n0 e to the power I into kx minus omega t. So I into omega minus I omega into n bar. So del del t may be replaced by minus I omega. And similarly, del del x will be replaced by ik. And like this. And del 2 del x2 will be replaced by ik whole square. Now, putting all these values in equation 9, 11, and 12. Ultimately, we got equation 22, 23, and 24. In these equations can be written in a matrix form. This is a system of linear homogeneous equation. Three unknowns, n0, u0, phi0. So three equations, three unknown. So the condition under which this equation 22, 23, 24 gives a non-trivial solution of n0, u0, and phi0 is that determinant should be equal to, determinant of the matrix should be equal to 0. Accordingly, this is the condition. Condition is given by equation 25. So by solving 25, we got the relation between omega and k. Omega square equal to k square by 1 plus k square. This is the dispersion relation. Or k equal to, or omega equal to k into 1 plus k square whole to the power minus up, or omega equal to k minus k cube by 2. This k is small k. It's a printing mistake, it becomes capital. So what is the phase velocity then? Plus sol. So if k is small, so we may neglect the rest terms. So phase velocity is omega by k equal to 1 by square root of 1 minus k square. Here it is clear that vp tends to 1 when k tends to 0. And vp tends to 0 as k tends to infinity. The group velocity is given by d omega dk, and group velocity will be 1 by 1 plus k square whole to the power c by 2. In this case, we have group velocity less than phase velocity for all k greater than 0. The group velocity is more important than the phase velocity as energy of the medium transferred with this velocity. So if for long wave as k tends to 0, the leading order approximation is omega equal to k, corresponding to non-dispersive acoustic waves with phase speed omega by k equal to 1. When this speed is same as the speed of the ionic acoustic wave CS, the long wave dispersion is weak, that is k lambda d much, much less than 1. This means that the wavelength is much larger than the wavelength. In these long waves, the electrons oscillate with the ions. The inertia of the wave is provided by the ions, and the restoring pressure force by the electrons. So ions give what? Inertia. And the restoring pressure force is given by the electrons. So omega, from here, equation 26, it can be written that omega equal to k minus k cube by 2 plus order of k to the power 5. So this phase, what is the phase of the wave? Kx minus omega t. So kx minus omega t can be written as k into x minus t plus half k cube t. If we replace omega, we get the relation of phase as a function of k only, and x t obviously there. So see, k into x minus t and k cube t both have some same dynamic status, at least dimension wise, in the phase. So in the phase, both x minus t and k cube t both have the same dynamic status if as far as the dimension is considered. So, and naturally k is small as the approximation of k is considered. So if we choose a small parameter epsilon such that k is a power of epsilon to the power half, then this x minus t will be tagged with epsilon to the power half, but t alone will be tagged with epsilon to the power 3 by 2. Here, x minus t is the traveling wave form. So the traveling wave form should be with epsilon to the power half, but the t time is with epsilon to the power 3 by 2. So accordingly, we need two different coordinate, which is called stretched coordinate. We tell them xi and tau. Xi equal to epsilon to the power half into x minus lambda t, and tau equal to epsilon to the power 3 by epsilon to the power 3 by 2 into t, where lambda is the Mach number. Now suppose we want to study the nonlinear cases, then we again express all the parameters, that is ion number density, velocity of the ion, potential, all in terms of epsilon, a power series, just to express as 32, 33, 34. So accordingly, del del x will be like 35, del del t will be like 36, and del 2 del x2 will be given by 37. Putting all these values in 5 to 7, we get this expression 38, 39, and 40. So do this calculation by yourself by using pen and paper at your house. Okay. So considering the lowest order term, from 38 to 40, first we get from 38 we get minus lambda, that is the lowest order term. these two terms, which into the power half term. So lambda del we substitute these equation into 31 to 34 and ultimately we get this. Do it at your house. These three equations we get for considering the terms, lowest order term, we get 41, 42, and 43. By integrating, we get 44, 45, and 46. And accordingly, replacing N1, Phi1, and U1 from this 44, 45, 46, we get the relation in lambda, which is lambda square equal to plus 1. It's lambda equal to plus minus 1, lambda square equal to plus 1. Now, we want to find out the next higher order of epsilon. And considering 31 and 34 in and 38 and 38 to 30, so 31 to 34 and 38 to 40, we get equation 48, 49, and 50. Do it yourself, it will be very easy. If you cannot, I will send you another. And just differentiating 50 ones and manipulating the all terms, that is substituting UI2 and Phi2, we get a relationship in Phi1, that is equation 51. It is the famous Kedebe equation. This is the evolution term, del Phi1 del tau. This is the nonlinear term, Phi1 del Phi1 del xi. And this is the dispersion term, half del 3 Phi1 del xi 3. This is the famous Kottrogg and De Vries equation. Suppose you want to find a steady state solution, then use the Galilean transformation, traveling wave type transformation, eta equal to xi minus u0 tau, and the solution will come. It's the solution I have done yesterday. In the previous lecture, you know, you got how to find out the solution. So from 51, solution of 51 is 52. Now damped and fourth Kedebe equation. Suppose instead of in this fluid equation, we consider the term new ID UI. This term comes due to collision. Okay. Now how to incorporate this new ID in the Kedebe equation? If we do the same normalization, considering any electron density same. Then ultimately we get a Kedebe equation of this type. This is the Kedebe equation. First three term gives the Kedebe. This is the evolution term. This is the nonlinear term. Second term. Third term is the dispersion term. The fourth term C Phi1. This term comes because of the collision. C equal to new ID 0 by 2. Here the new ID 0. Came in equation 54 in the right hand side. This is the force due to collision. So the collision causes the damping in the equation. Suppose we consider that an external additional applied force, B del S to del J, also appear in equation 61. And now we want to, or we shall find out the approximate analytical solution of different types of equations of this type. So, for simplicity, we assume S2 as a sinusoidal wave with sine omega t or cos omega t. So, ultimately, we consider equation 62, that is del phi 1 del tau plus A phi 1 del phi 1 del xi plus B del C phi 1 del xi 3 plus C phi 1, this one is equal to F0 cos omega t. This equation is termed as damped and forced Kedebe equation. That is, Kedebe equation is damping and forcing term. So if C and F0 are 0, then equation 62 gives the original Kedebe equation whose solution is given by equation 63. It is known that the Kedebe equation satisfies infinite conservation law. One such conservation law is माइनस इनफिनिटी टू प्लस इनफिनिटी फाइव ऑन स्क्वायर डीसाई इज कंजर्व, दैट इज डी, दैट इज इफ वी टेक द डेरिवेटिव ऑफ दिस इक्वेशन विथ रेस्पेक्ट टू टाउ देन इट विल बी जीरो. सो डी आई डी टाउ विल बी जीरो. But it's true only for KdV equation. Let us assume that even in presence of this damping and forcing term, even in presence of this damping and forcing term, there is conservation of soliton, that is minus infinity to plus infinity phi square dxi. It is the same. That is, even for this equation 62, this is preserved. With a small change, that is provided that in the solution 63, where m, omega, and phi m are constant, if these are independent of, these are function of time. That is, we impose the conservation principle on this damped and forced KdV equation, and accordingly, we made the changes on the amplitude, velocity and width of the solitary waves, which are not dependent on t, we make them dependent on t. So let us assume that this solution, approximate solution, it's not exact solution, approximate analytical solution of 62 will be 65, provided phi, m and omega are function of tau, and they is satisfied this 64, equation 64, this conservation principle of the KdV equation. So just if we do the calculation, then we get equation 66. If we differentiate 64 with respect to tau and using 62, we can obtain this equation, and accordingly we can find out I, that is 24 root b by a square m to the power 3 by 2 tau. And using 66 and 67, we find out the expression for m. This is the expression for m tau. That is, initially, for KdV equation, m tau is nothing but this m. But because of the presence of damping term and forcing term, whole things appear. That is, in the approximate analytical solution, the solution, if we assume that the solution is same as that of phi 0, phi m sec square m into tau by omega t, provided this phi m, m and omega, they dependent on tau, then tau dependency will be given by this equation, m tau equal to m minus this into to the power minus 4 by 3 c tau plus this into this. If tau is 0 and f0 is 0, if c is 0 and f0 is 0, not tau, c is 0 and f0 is 0, the same tau simply will be capital M, which gives equation 63. So this is nothing but some extension of equation 63. So this is the way by which we can handle such type of evolution equation whose exact analytical solution is not obtained. Their approximate solution may be obtained by considering these approximations. So the figures are plotted. You can plot the figures for different parameter values. I think this much for today. Next day, I will tell, do these calculations, otherwise it will be tough for you, okay? For a calculation, you can do this. Okay, I will tell you today, I will tell you today. Okay, I will tell you today, I will tell you today. শুনতে পাচ্ছ? হ্যালো,
ঠিক আছে স্যার,
হ্যাঁ এখান পর্যন্ত ক্যালকুলেশন করো, পরের দিন আরেকটু পড়াবো, হ্যাঁ থ্যাংক ইউ।